Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 17 of our Golang course. In the last lesson, we covered arrays and also looked at some of the shortcomings of arrays in Go. We said slices help overcome shortcomings of arrays. So in this lesson, we will be covering slices in Go. So let's dive in and start our journey. Slices in Go are wrappers around array. A slice under the hood uses an array to store its data. That means when you're working with slices, you're working with arrays behind the scenes, but slices hide the complexity of managing the underlying array from the user. An example of slicing managing the underlying array for you is creating a new array and moving to a new bigger array when required. This helps the user overcome the pitfalls of array like fixed length. The length of slice can increase and is not fixed, so you can keep adding as many elements as you like to the slice. The length of slice is also not attached to the type of the slice, which allows you to pass a slice of any size to a function, for example. This would be a problem if the function accepted an array, as you would need to have to specify the length of the array that the function accepts. If we said function should accept an array of length 2, then Go will only allow us to pass an array of length 2, whereas if the function accepts a slice, it can accept a slice of any size, which is obviously more practical. That is again because the length of the array lives on the type, and Go being a strongly typed language doesn't allow different type to be used when you have an array of a specific type. Along with the length of the slice, it also has a capacity. The length and capacity of the slice are two different properties. Let us understand that with a high-level example. Here in the example that we have, you can see we have a slice which is managing or referencing an array for us. The length of the slice is the number of elements currently stored in the underlying array, which is 3. So it stores 10, 30 and 5, giving the length 3. The capacity, on the other hand, is the total length of the underlying array that the slice has provisioned for us, which in this case is 5. Usually, when you create a slice, it will always provision an array of greater capacity than required. The additional capacity is used to store elements that you add to the slice so that it does not have to create a new array each time you add a value to the slice. You can use the len function just like arrays to get the length of the slice and use the cap function to get the capacity of the slice. You can also use the cap function for arrays too, but the return value will be always the same as that of a len function. So what happens when you keep adding more and more elements to the slice and the length of the underlying array reaches the capacity of the slice? Let's cover that in the next section. When you create a slice of certain length, the algorithm used by Go to manage slices will create an array that is usually double the length of the slice to accommodate additional values when required. When you reach the capacity of the slice algorithm of Go will create a new array of bigger size, usually bigger by 50 to 25% from the current capacity, and copy over the values from the old array to the new array and start using it while discarding the older one. This allows you to keep adding values to slices as required. It can be a performance problem for bigger slices which grow at a rapid rate, as Go would keep on creating new array to accommodate new values and moving values from the old array to the new one. But usually it is fine unless the slice is too big. Now let us see how we can declare and initialize a slice in Go. If you remember from the last lesson, when you create an array, you need to provide a length of array. This is how slice declaration is different from that of an array. For slice, length is not declared when you are declaring a slice. As you can see from the first example here, we are creating a nil slice. We will come back to nil later. For now, let us concentrate on slice declaration. As you can see, we are not passing any length when declaring a slice. In fact, all slice declaration examples are the same, in that we don't pass a length. If length is passed, Go will create an array instead. In the second example, we are again creating an integer slice of length 5, initializing the 0 index value to 1, the 1 index to 2, 3, 4, and 5. Similar to arrays, we can also create sparse slices. The last example here is interesting, as we are using the inbuilt make function to create a slice of type int and length 0. Let us learn more about the make function now. The universal make function can be used to create a slice as we saw in the previous slide. The make function takes the type as the first argument, followed by the length of the slice as the second argument, and capacity as an optional argument when creating a slice. Usually, we don't normally pass the capacity of the slice, but again, if you know the maximum number of elements that you are going to store in a slice, you can pass in the capacity of the slice as the third argument. Let us look at some examples of creating a slice with the make function. In the first example, we are creating an int slice of length 5. This will initialize a slice of length 5 with all 5 elements in the slice assigned the 0 value for integer, which is 0. So, if you need to store a new value at any of the 5 indices that we initialized with the 0 value, you would need to use the index of the value to update the value in the slice, otherwise they will remain 0. Next, we are creating a string slice of length 5 but a capacity of 10. This will create a slice that has an underlying array of size 10 but with only the first 5 elements initialized to the 0 value of a string, which is an empty string. Last, we have a make function that creates an int slice with a length of 0 and capacity 10. Again, you don't really need to worry about the capacity of the slice, as the Go slice algorithm will handle it for you, or use the make function to create a slice, but this is an option that you should be aware of. All along the lesson, we have talked about how elements can be added to a slice and how the slice length can be increased as needed. We add values to a slice with the globally or universally available append function. The append function is used to append a new value to end of a slice. It is important to remember that the Go compiler will throw an error if the return value from the append function is not used. Usually, you would assign the return value from the append function to the slice that you appended to. Now, let us look at some examples of the append function. As you can see from the example, the first argument to the append function is the slice itself that you are appending the value to. The next argument is the value that you want to append to the slice. As you can see from our next example, you can pass multiple values to append to a slice. So here, you see we are appending 4, 2, 5, 6 in order to slice A. In the third example, we are using the spread operator to actually append values from a different slice to the current slice. So B can be a slice and we are appending all the values from B into A. Till now, we have mostly covered how slices are different from arrays. In this slide, let us cover how they are similar to arrays. Just like arrays, you can fetch or manipulate the element of a slice using the index of the element. Both slices and arrays are zero index, that is, the first element of both slice and array is at index 0. The same indexing rule applies for slices as for arrays. You cannot have a negative index for a slice or array, and you cannot access index beyond the last element of the slice or array, which is length minus 1. Now, as mentioned before, let us cover the nil slice and empty slice concept. Nil in Go is different from null, as you may have seen in other programming languages. Nil in Go represents lack of value and type. As we go along the course, we will see how nil is useful. The zero value for a slice is nil. As we covered earlier, when we initialized a slice, the slice creates an underlying array to store its data. A nil slice, on the other hand, when created, does not have an underlying array associated with it. The underlying array will only be initialized when you start adding values to the nil slice. An empty slice, on the other hand, is a slice which has an underlying array associated with it but with no elements in it or is of zero length. This is how we would create a nil slice in Go. We are saying A is a slice of type int. If you check this slice to be nil, it will be always true. It's only when you add a value or assign an empty slice to it that the underlying array will be initialized. If you check the length and the capacity of nil slice using the len or the cap function, it will return 0 just like an empty slice. But again, equating an empty slice to nil will lead to false, while equating a nil slice to nil will be always true. An empty slice, on the other hand, can be created with curly braces following the square braces. This way, the slice will be initialized with the underlying array, but the length of the slice will be 0. That's it for this lesson. We will cover what we have learned here about slices with code in the next lesson. If you have any questions, please feel free to post a comment under the video or reach out to the Discord server. Thanks for watching the video. See you in the next lesson.